Welcome, Illumineers. X-TCG Kingdom here, bringing you my Can a Beauty Be Beastly? A new Amethyst Emerald deck from Ursula's Return with the new cards from Beauty and the Beast added to the deck. Let's take a look at the deck, shall we? Well, here's the deck. We're primarily trying to use as much Beauty and the Beast cards as possible to help the deck function. It is a moving damage type of deck. You actually move damage from other characters, your own or your opponents, to other characters on the field. Mostly your opponents, because it doesn't really let you choose yourself. I found out this out during the gameplay that you can't move your damage from your opponent's characters to yours if it actually does help in certain situations. We are trying to use a bunch of the bell and the shift bells to change our damage to our opponent. We are going to be using the Vision Slate to help stop Red versus Ruby get their draw engine off, because they do like to hurt themselves to get some free draws off. And we are trying to get some Beast and Bell in here so that we can actually do more damage. We have some cards that will help us get draw power or control the field with We Don't Talk About Bruno and the Mystical Rose, and later on the Rose Lantern too. We do want to use quite a few of the Beauty and the Beast cards with Mrs. Potts, even though there's no draw with it. It's just more theme based. You can change up some of these cards if you want, but I do recommend this build for the more challenging individuals. We'll see some of the gameplay here in a moment, which I am going to show you right here for the first game. It is a whole bunch of cards that we're just trying to see going on to first, second, for third and fourth turn. We don't see any of our big end game cards right now, so we're going to wait for our opponent to show us what they got. They got Steel and Ruby. So we are trying to dig for our Vision, I think it's called Vision Slate again? Yeah, to help us like make sure that damage stays on our opponent permanently. And they do fire the cannons on our chip. Wow, we don't mind them using their destruction on our early game. It's okay. I'm bringing out a two cost two lore quester, which is the magical maid. As you can see, I have a Madame Medusa. Madame Mim in my hand that I want to start bringing out so it can start taking damage, and I want to start bringing out the bell as soon as I can. So I'm right now trying to debate whether I want to bring out the wardrobe or not. I choose not to in favor of bringing out the Mad Mim so I can get some damage. I want them to use that ability of the fox there to do some ping damage on my Mad Mim so I can start moving my damage to the Mulan. They drop a whole bunch of characters down right away on the field here. And me thinking that they were going to quest or anything, they actually didn't read their card. They could have quested and got some readying up with LeFou. I decided to sing with the Madame Mim because I want them to try going into her. I just decided to ink. We don't want to talk about Bruno because it's going to be a while before we play it. I bring out two cards that are equally up to four. One with the Rose for my Bell for next turn, and one so I can start questing with the magical maid again. And then they start trading off some of their stuff. They do their Robin Hood ping damage on my Madame Mim, and this requesting. I don't mind this because I'm going to just ink another Mystical Rose, and then bring out a chip, and then sing the Friends on the Other Side to get some more draws in. I am going to try doing some more questing before they decide to get in their characters to attack into mine. They bring out a shifted Robin Hood, which is unfortunate for me because now I have to deal with this without having to kill it through quest, through battling. So I am looking at my hand, see that I have some setup for Bell to start making plays of that, get rid of my wardrobe because I don't need it anymore. I am going to look at what I want to do. I decided to bring out the Bell here so I can start moving damage from the Robin Hood to something else to kill it, so I can actually bring out my other Bell on a later date. I am now passing turn because I don't want to get that Robin Hood's free festival to go off. I decide to play. We don't talk about singing. We don't talk about Bruno. But that is both his Robinsons back to his hand and randomly discard a card. I check his hand to see if he has a song. He does. He has the Be Prepared, so I get rid of that immediately. Go into the block, the bodyguard, and then now I have my one damage on my characters that I need to use my new bell that's in the hand. She'll move one damage from any character I have to my opponent's character, or one of their opponent's characters to another character they have. But you do still have to target that character, so it does not get around the ward effects. So they have a Mulan out, and they hard drop a Robin Hood. I decide to sing again. We don't talk about Bruno, or hard play it. I end up hard playing it because I don't need to worry about singing right now. I am going to just quest with everything, and then pass the turn. I'm just now caught up to their ink that they have managed to gain through this whole time of me trying to do my setup. I still have that rows on the field that I will do up to three of my damage to something else on their side of the field. I side the quest with everything and then pass turn. I want them to attack into my character with the Mulan. It is a big risk because they could be ready to do the Floodborn Mulan and then get rid of a bunch of my characters. But they can't catch up with what they have now. I give them the good game, I give it to you back, and then I just decide the quest and win from here. And with that, it's game's closed. Now we're going on to our next game. We are going to go through our hand, get rid of a whole bunch of cards that we don't need, at least in the first couple of turns. But you still want that ship because we still want it on turn one, and then we want the Ursula for turn two so we can check hands. It's good to have the morph so that we can go into any shift bells that we get, because there is quite a few. We literally want to get rid of that bell, bring out a chip, and then we are facing off against another Ruby deck, so this is all good for me. I do really wish I had the vision slate against anything that's Ruby, because I don't want them to heal. I check their hand with Ursula and then I quest with my chip. I don't mind my chip being killed off by being attacked. It's a good trade-off for me, and they bring out a Minnie Mouse that's evasive. And how do I deal with this? Well, in this deck, it again does move damage, so I can move my damage from one of those Mulans onto her other one to destroy it without even attacking it. And then that's going to be a key thing for this. The game does like glitch out for a quick second there, which has been happening a lot lately with this new update to Dreamborn. But the plan is for me, or still, we're back onto it, is to get more damage out and then hit those minis so that they don't continuously quest for lots of lore. I just need something to attack first, though, or some for me to attack into them. That's the problem here. So I bring out the rose, and then I start questing for as much as I can, except for the bell, because I want to keep her out in case I get another shift bell, or if they start hacking into my characters, and then I can use the rose to move three damage from a character onto another one of those mini mouses and kill them. They're going to quest with both mini mouses, and I don't mind that. They choose to get rid of both characters because people are actually starting to read what the bell does throughout the games today. They have to suffer from we don't talk about Bruno. They've got a card from in their hand, trying to get rid of their mini mouses. Now I'll decide to quest and try to get them to attack into my character. They are still playing red, or Ruby, so we do have to watch out for some of those like Mauis or Be Prepareds. They do drop two minis, which they probably don't want to be prepared themselves on that. We do another Bruno, and we put a card back to hand. We get the mini out of the hand, which is great because it is a random card from the hand. It's not anything guaranteed. We decide the quest with the Ursula, and then we are going to move on to the next turn. They do drop a Goofy and get two lore instantly, which is not great for me, but I do still get my damage that I'm looking for. But now I have to focus in on that Goofy. So I'm deciding to what to do, bring out the Beast, and the Beast has Rush, and it could force down other characters. I decide to put the rose into the Beast, which will then turn, which was an accident, which it should have been the bell that I used. I click selected because of how the game works and not knowing how the selection works. It should have been the selecting the bell, putting the damage from the Beast onto the Minnie Mouse, and that's what should have been, not just selecting the beast for more lore. But even though we have that, we still have our damage, so that is okay. We are now move our quest, and we're going to see what we can get off the top of our deck. We get a morph, we drop another bell, and we move damage to the mini. And then we just do our kill action that kills a damaged character. So we are now questing now, and hopefully going to have the Hades trade up into one of our characters. They could always trade into the beast, which I don't mind. They attack the Ursula because they don't want the Goofy to die. And it's a good plan. I don't have any damaged characters myself. I did draw into another one of my kill actions there, and I just quest from here. They are now trying to catch up to me in field presence. They bring out another Goofy, which is unfortunate. I do shift a bell and then remove two of my damage off my bell and then put it on the Goofy and then quest with both these characters. And then I'm now 1 point away. If they had one more Goofy, I could have won. But at this point, they have nothing except for be prepared. If that's what it's going to be of, and I decided, no, it's not. And they concede. They're moving on from there. And we are on our next game. We are definitely taking out all these bells out of our hand. We don't need this many bells to go on turn one. We are trying to dig for a chip, and we did get one. We are always looking for the chip for our turn one, because we still want something to do. And we want our opponent to focus on the chips. We're playing against, I guess, another Ruby deck this time around. And we are playing against Emerald Ruby. And we are looking at the hand. We find out it is a negative lure green Ruby deck. So we're on a tight schedule for the Lyle Tiberius to come out before we start losing lore like crazy. So we are going to decide to drop our bell after doing some damage to the Ursula and move the damage to the cat so it just dies, which is awesome. I love it. I love being able to target stuff that usually you can't kill. It's this cleric combination. They bring out the Lyle and then they force me to have to attack, which I can't attack anything, so it just becomes a dead card on the field with her. I just had to sing to draw some more cards. I do remember that item up there for Emerald is every time you saw an opponent sings a song, they get to draw a card. And I had to take that risk for me to start playing more characters out and start questing. So I'm still trying to quest like crazy, and I'm trying to get that Lyle to the turn sideways so I can do some damage into it, because I do have another bell that can instantly kill it as long as I put something else into it. They do bring out another Lyle, which is unfortunate for me, and then I decide to do some damage with the turned now sideways bell, and I will shift into the new bell and remove all my bell's damage and put it onto the Lyle. Unfortunately, killing it even this way, I still lose a lore because of how the Lyle still works. It doesn't matter how the character's dead, it just, as long as it gets banished, it is still an egg on lore for me. They ink some other cards up, and then they are going to decide if they want to keep trying to make me attack into their characters. They drop a Donald Duck and then decide to not quest. I see that and loading up my field and starting the quest with everything I got, because I want to make sure I have a good lead against this deck. I pass turn, they are activating the Donald Duck's ability. I'm sure I'm going to take that while I still can. I did get my Vision Plate. This deck doesn't need to worry too much about the healing portion of green and ruby. So or Emerald and Ruby, so I don't need to worry about that. They do play the Donald, get some questing in, and then force my bell to be reckless. I just get rid of my Vision Plate, that's not good, bring out the beast, and I start questing with all the characters I have, and then I pass turn. I will end up losing two lore every time a character dies, even if they attack into my character to kill it. They make me lose a lore. Now, in this case, it's two, which is unfortunate for me. If anything on their side of the field survives, though, I can start moving damage to their characters if I get more bells, or I have the two cards in my hand that kill damaged characters. Now, I do love that I have the two Ring the Bells for both those Tiberiuses. If they turn sideways at all, they choose to get rid of one of their LeFlu to make me lose two lore, which is quite annoying, because now, no matter how much I'm trying to get on the field. They are getting more and more characters back, and it became harder and harder for me to win. They did sing together a, I think it was Under the Sea, yeah, which returned all my low-end characters back to my deck. There were two costs or less, I believe. Yeah, so I have my beast. I have my beast attack into the Lyle. I still lose the lore. I'm just trying to get rid of those Lyles as much as I can. I bring out another beast, move into the lore, the Lyle, and then I have my bell quest, and then I have my my wardrobe sing again. That card for the green item that lets them draw every time I sing a song is quite annoying. And I do like it. I like it a lot. It's going to be a really good card, against, especially against like meta decks like Steel Song or any Steel Song variants or Ember Song, any of them really. But yeah, they brings out their next Lyle, which is kind of getting annoying now because they're not really processing getting more lore on their side of the field. They're just delaying the inevitable for my side. They do have a Diablo now, so they can still get some more draws off, and there's the damage I need for Donald Duck. I just hope that I can get into damage. I do have the item I just played from last turn, the Rose Lantern, which lets me move damage to other characters, and then I could actually use my kill action in my hand. Noticing this, I moved the Donald to the wrong character. I did it to the Diablo, and I should have did it to Lyle. And then use the kill action on Lyle, but now I just made myself a lot harder to finish this game out and close it out. I would have been one character short, questing character short to actually get to my 20 before I would have lost my whole bunch of my field. So I decided to attack into the Donald, so the Donald's draw engine would be over. I did not expect to find them using the John Silver, and then they run into a bunch of the characters into my characters, so that I lose a bunch with the Prince Eric, and then they get some more off of me for annoying damage portion of the Reckless that they're going to make my characters do. Diablo still has a damage, so I can't. I moved the damage to the from my bell onto the John Silver, and then kill it with the one kill action that I have there. I have two bells in hand that I'm going to hard drop pretty soon, and that way I can get just like finish off the game and close out the game here. But this Lyle is really making it hard to do any of the control aspects with the control aspects of Lyle into my characters. They're dropping a whole bunch of characters again into the field, and they are going to decide if they want to get rid of the Diablo or quest with it. They are trying to nag me lore as much as they can, as long as they have that Lyle out. They did sacrifice their Diablo to nag me lore, which is unfortunate for me. I am going to hard play the bell, and then move my damage from my other bell to the Lyle, which should have been done a lot sooner. Quest with my characters to get to 17, and then they now have an Eric that can get rid of one of my characters and possibly get me even lower and lower. They attack with the Eric. Eric dies. I lose a lore. I choose my other bell that's not ready. They sacrifice another character to make me lose another lore, and it's just getting on repeat over here over and over again. They bring out the flute already up the Lyle, so I can't challenge into it, which I'm trying to really do. I drop a bell, and then I am going to pass. I'm just at this point not going to give them any targets to kill on my side, so I can lose lore. And then they accidentally use their wildcat on the wrong item, which is okay with for me. It doesn't really matter at this point. My item won't help me much in this part. I drop another bell, and then I am going to ink my beast because there's no point, and I'm not going to quest with anything yet because I'm going to do my questing all in one shot. And they drop their last character. They can't catch up to me for no matter how much lore they accumulate here. And they don't have anything to neg me lore, so With that, that's a good, it's a good game, and they concede. We're on to our next game. And I am trying to get a perfect hand with the chip. I have two of the shift bells. I decided to keep the bell that lets me remove someone's hand if they go challenge into it, and hopefully trying to find a morph, which would help, you know, a lot here. I didn't get any, but it is a ruby and a amethyst deck that we're facing up against now. I drop the magical maid into the ink, and then I drop my chip. So at least I have a turn one play. They are looking at the chip, thinking it's something special. Nothing special, just a vanilla 2/2. And they bring out a Flynn. I drop my Rose Lantern into the ink and then check their hand to see if they have anything special in there. It's two Goofies and a Mad Mim, so we have a few turns before those start going off. I decide that I need to start doing damage so I can get my damage counters to move the things, and I hack into the Olaf. They are dropping a Pinocchio to turn my Ursula sideways so that they can exert my Ursula so that they can. That's what I thought they were going to do, but they ended up just targeting nothing instead. So it's kind of weird. They had the quest with the Flynn, and then I attack with the Ursula into Flynn so I start doing damage onto my characters, and then bring out my bell, and then I move the damage from my Ursula to the Flynn so I don't have to worry about the Flynn getting any kind of bonus off. My opponent goes. They're at 3 lore now. I'm waiting for them to possibly bring out the Goofy and start getting some free questing off of that just by attacking into my characters. We have Pinocchio on board, and I have a shift bell that I could end up destroying any kind of aggression that any rush characters have with these four. They're taking their sweet time trying to figure out if they want to, what they want to do, but it's pretty obvious the play that they can have. They can actually just play their location that they had in their hand, or they can do the one of the two Goofies and get some lore off of it. They decide that they're going to pass turn, and we are like, all right. So we put our next card into our ink. We quest with our Ursula, give them a single target to go after, and then they bring out the Goofy like they should have in the last turn. Fortunately for me, the Goofy is not as strong as most rush targets, and I bring out the bell. I take the damage that are off my bell and put it all onto the Pinocchio so they don't have anything to bounce with. I now have a bunch of Unicos in hand and we don't talk about Bruno. It's just unfortunate. We get rid of the we don't talk about Bruno. We bring out the beast, and then we attack into the castle and kill it immediately. People forget that the original beast from set one has rush, and it would actually turn any damaged characters into the Exert state, so you can just challenge them right away, which is pretty neat. I decided to keep the morph in hand in case there is a be prepared, because they are now at 7 ink. I decided to try to bait out the be prepared and bring out a big bell. I'm trying to get them to activate any board wipes or anything like that. That way I can start playing for the next hand. They try to decide what they want to do with the Madame Medusa. They go into my beast, because I guess that's a harder to play. I decide to kill off my bell with the action that they play that's just no different than Madame Medusa. I bring out the bell, I put some ink in, and then I have, again, another turn to play all my characters here. I'm going to quest with my bell. I'm going to bring out the wardrobe. And then I'm going to pass turn. I want that Madame Medusa to try to get rid of my bell so they get rid of their hand, which happens. They do damage to their character, and I move it to the Pegasus. And then I use my wardrobe to kill off both characters. And then I just bounce the Madame Mim, the bell back to hand, so I have more control over the field again if something happens. They bring out another Pinocchio with Turn My Guy Sideways, and nothing happens from there. I bring out a beast, and then I start questing with my Madame Medusa. They are going to keep playing here and seeing if they have anything else. They do not, and that's it. I do recommend the deck. You can definitely do some changes to it, but it's all in all a great deck. And if you like this content and like my videos, please just like and subscribe, and I hope to see you guys next time. Thank you. Bye.